So we have to make courses. We have India Century Mission. It has to make courses and action plans to do in all these areas. The third is rural development. And fourth thing is, we know how to behave when we are happy and safe. How to behave if you are in disasters, in communal disharmony and clashes. That type of disaster management and risk management and crisis control must be taught to the public at all. We have to create the resources management courses for the people, how to maintain the global and natural resources and prevent exploitation of the natural resources. I want to say two things very simply here. We are having a curse. The curse is responsible for the degradation. And we want development and we want a fuel for the development. We are having a lot of curse. Whenever the infraspecial entities like animals, birds and nature is mistreated, like the famous Victor Hugo, before a few centuries we have been teaching human beings how to behave with fellow humans. Now he is in such a pathetic condition, he must be taught how to behave with nature, animals, birds and insects. Such is the situation of these people. So these natural global resources maintenance must be there. If the persons he mistreats or ill-treats his inferior species, he is mistreated and he is punished by nature. Nature is nothing but the will of God. It is the shadow of God. He is punished by God in the form of the natural resources refusal or in the form of natural disasters and man-made calamities. These things are the curses. Wisdom the curses and what are the methodologies for eradication of the same. Second, what are the fuels that we want to get from the youth community, think tanks, academicians, responsible politicians and other members of the society, make it as a fuel, efficacious fuel to run this dynamism to get into fructification. So, harmony, religious harmony, domestic and social harmony must be taught. How to behave with your parents, how to maintain husband and wife relationship. As these things are just trivially, they must not be concerned, because an unhealthy and happy family, that only contributes an unhealthy nation. If your person is disturbed, for example, if your person is disturbed, he is betrayed by the society for employment resources. If he is a normal person, he will get into depression. But if the same person is fueled by circumstances, he will get into agitation, becoming a terrorist. He will spoil a lot of people, he will burn all the public properties and he will destroy everything. So we must not take this into trivial consideration, and teaching this way of harmony, self-reliance for our nation in energy resources, that is also very much essential. So considering these energy resources, harmony, training and teaching, education, employment sources, rural employment sources, improving scientific temper and indigenous innovations in the nation, that is also very much important. Infrastructure management by roads, by essential construction of buildings and everything. So all of these things must be enlisted. It cannot be completed both in an oration or in implementation within the shortest duration. It requires a practical time. And certainly I believe that we have reached the dawn, and certainly it is going to not only radiate the persons available inside, it is having, the truth is having two powers. One is radiation and permeation. It radiates the persons who are available here, but it permeates the atmosphere in silence. It gets into the photomolecule particle and it vibrates. It details its inward nature, the nucleus of the essentialities of the truth, and it gets into all people who are like-minded and like-spirited. And I believe that with the wishes and blessings of already we used today, whenever you take a task of God, whenever you take a task that is pre-sanctioned by God, whenever you take a task that is more or less proximate to divinity, eternity, purity and global righteousness, it is pre-sanctioned, pre-endorsed, pre-approved and pre-vitalized by God himself. So we are not taking a project which is for our own welfare, it is not for the collective welfare of a secular or a different type of community, it is for the global welfare. So we believe that we have the pre-sanctioned endorsement of God, and God resides in us as spirit, the spirit of speech, the spirit of action and the spirit of fructification of all of our collective and committed actions. I believe that this is going to be a great success, and we need not worry about the crowd at all, because of two reasons. One, we have to organize it in such a manner that we have to give advertisements, register the seats. We don't say that the spiritualism and all of these things, they don't affect much crowd. It is not like that. We see the Yogiram, the Ramdev Baba is there. He is from North India and he teaches yoga, and lots of people are there. Even there are crowd pullers like cine artisans and musicians and famous other political and social celebrities. We used to have also spiritual celebrities who are allurer of mass crowds. It is because of their organization skill, media representation, more than what you have, how you present it in the society and through what channel and media, that is the great thing that gives you the effect. So the same thing, well organized, being presented in such an attractive, simple as well as a provoking manner. For example, if you say that how to manage your family and how to that is engross yourself in your work with success and how to increase your wealth management, how to be a successful entrepreneur, all of these things which are directly connected with the people for immediate approach. Immediate, and remote approaches are there. So religion or the society, nation and globe, they are in the remote approach of the people, and the immediate things are so much concerned with the knowledge improvement, knowledge management and status management. Immediate requirement are clearment from, that is clearing from loans and clearing from their personal other predicaments and other things. Then mental peace and satisfaction, physical salubrity, all of these things are immediate requirements of the public. And whenever a person contacts something about immediate requirements, they are more attracted. We want people who are realized and committed. Even though we want some people to be attracted as a preliminary, attracting according to me, it is an incentive and preliminary way, and mere attraction that will not bring commitment. If it is not with commitment, it is not going to be the fruit at all. So by properly making the India Century Mission as a network, for example, we can have net enrollment, net magazines and journals, e-journals we can start conducting a proper way of course of India Century Mission in schools, in corporate offices, and also for the householders and housewives in the form of either practical workshop as well as a symposium, and also in the form of distance education, then evening school, various other methodologies, even EduSat, Info School, all of these modern education methods are there. Certainly we are going to plan them at the time of implementation of this India Century Mission as an institutionalized, PAKA, precise, consummate project. We feel that we will be having thronging crowds who are really thirst of spiritual wisdom and who are really brave enough to contribute something for the society by their collective integrity, with sacrifice, service and sincerity. I have already revealed it. So I wish and bless, and I also pray to the lotus feet of the great ultimate reality Narayana to shower his choicest benedictions on the persons available here and persons who are available for the same mission not available in the auditorium, to have a collective integrity and come forward to organize it under the able leadership of N.S. Ramaswamy. Narayana, Narayana, Narayana.
Yes, various kinds of networks, institutional arrangements, holistic approach towards propagation, dissemination, and you, all of us who are gathered here, those who think it's worth proceeding, let's do that. With these words, either we break for tea, coffee, which is ready, and then Justice Ramacharya shall speak, or Justice Ramacharya shall speak and then we break. There is Krishna, is the coffee ready? Then we break and come back. Or, coffee is ready? No. Continue with the Ramajoy. Sir, may I request? Yes, yes, Ramajoy. How do I describe him? I was in a depressed mood. The moment I said I would speak about Ramajoy, my energy has come back. It has come many times to our academy, wrote on Dharma, written several books on Sanatana Dharma, various interpretations in various languages. Yes, too. A source of strength and blessing to me personally and to everybody in this part of the world and India too. May I request him to speak on it.
Brothers and sisters, you have already heard a speech full of wisdom by Sri Rajshekharan, and has also heard a powerful keynote address by Chakravarti Swamiji. Ramaswamy has been saying more than once about the number of invitations he has sent and the number of persons present here. I want to remind Ramaswamy of the words of Will Durant in History of Civilization, wherein he said, the reformations or changes in the human society will come up